Hi, I'm Tiny Captain. We're not gonna talk about flat earthers and how wrong they are. Today, it's about conspiracy nuts, especially anti-vaxxers. Vaccines are a well-known subject among conspiracy nuts, and with the COVID pandemic, it opened a whole new era. A lot of child diseases were stopped from spreading by vaccines. As a sailor, we used to get way more vaccines, such as vaccines against diseases like
yellow fever, cholera, hepatitis, typhoid fever, diphtheria, tetanus, and polio.
Nowadays, those countries that had those diseases mostly have it under control. And here is how. If only a few people get vaccinated, the virus can spread. But if more than 70% of the population get vaccinated, the virus is under control. And now we get to a dangerous conspiracy nut. Lange Frans is a Dutch rapper that had some hits between 2004 and 2010.
Kom uit het land van kroketten, frikadellen, die je tot aan de Spaanse kust kunt bestellen.
Yeah, not really my cup of tea. He turned out to be a conspiracy nutcase, and he started a podcast talk show about this subject on YouTube. A Dutch comedy talk show had an episode about it. And one of Arjen Lubach's topics was, you guessed it, Lange Frans. Arjen Lubach got the watchers curious and they looked it up on the internet. Meanwhile, Lange Frans got banned and he blamed Arjen Lubach.
My whole YouTube account is deleted by YouTube. Also all my own music on my channel. I think it's really a shame. You made me cry, Arjen Lubach. Thank you. Maybe you, with your inside contacts at YouTube, can ask for at least my music back, heart emoji.
Because of the show, his channel spiked. If your channel spikes, YouTube will check your contents and, of course, conspiracy theories get your channel banned. And then he decided to continue on his own website.
Lieve mensen,
vrienden, the automatic subtitles are not completely correct anyway. And on his podcast, he had some particular persons with the same dangerous state of mind. Like Elke de Klerk. She's a member of the World Doctors Alliance and works together with a group called Viruswaanzin. They changed their name to Viruswaarheid because they were marked as a hate group. Here is one of her speeches.
Het vaccin, daar zitten nanopartikels in. En met die nanopartikels worden wij officieel eigendom van Microsoft. Ja. En zo wil ik ook vertellen dat er steeds meer bewijs komt voor het feit dat in de tests, de PCR-tests, de PCR-gate, zie ik hier, dat het nog erger is dat het dus ook de PCR-test is een soort vaccinatie, een nasale vaccinatie. Dus ik roep ook op, stop met testen, want het lijkt erop dat je al gevaccineerd bent als je die test neemt.
So, according to her standard, 57% of the Dutch population already had the nasal vaccine. And because we just started, 3% now had the real vaccine. So, 10% more to go, and we're at 70%. And the Netherlands is saved. Well, no.
That's not how it works. That's not how any of this works.
But Lange Frans is into way more conspiracies.
From Lange Frans. Artie is longer, good lord, there are an implausible large number of pedophiles in the halls of power. And this has been the case for decades.
Maybe.
It's all about the money.
Some are fighting this in the media, and some are trying to get to him in his own field.
If you turn the logo of Lange Frans on his side, you get the early Coptic letter Ruk, the symbol of the child butcher ox god Onan. This is not a coincidence. Wake up, people.
And with that I'll say, I see you another day. This was Tiny Captain, over and out.